Well, I have spent 2 important years of my life there at the campus of Pannagar University, and I got to know some of the astounding facts and its rich history. So I decided to make a video and share it with you. Beginning with the introduction, let's zoom in the location of Pannagar University. It is located in the Uttarakhand state of India, or to be more precise, in the Udham Singh Nagar district of Uttarakhand. The university campus is located at 250 km from Delhi. Some of the famous nearby towns are Rudrapur, Haldwani, and Nainital. Two national highways, Bareilly-Nainital National Highway and NH-109, intersect the campus. Coming to the area of the campus, the area is really huge. The campus is spread over an area of 12,661 acres, which makes it the second largest university in the world in terms of area. For those who could not imagine how much 12,667 acres is, let me help you. The area of this university is greater than the combined area of various institutes in India, including JNU, these 6 IITs, Banaras Hindu University, Delhi University, Punjab University, and still there is a lot area left which can accommodate whole of Central Vista, White House of USA, CERN in Europe, and the country of Monaco and Vatican City. You must be wondering why and what they do with so much area. To answer that, let me take you back to the year 1947.
At the stroke of the midnight hour, when the world sleeps, India will awake to life and freedom.
Frankly, I've never seen so many people. They must be here literally in their hundreds of thousands. A great, swarming, excited, cheering, enthusiastic Indian crowd. A symbol we all wish we were here for the future hope and prosperity of the new Dominion of India.
Finally, India became an independent country, but it was a food deficit country and had to depend on imports from other countries to feed the citizens. Now, to solve the problem of food scarcity in India, various decisions were taken, out of which the first Education Commission of India, formed in 1949, led by Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan, recommended setting up rural universities in India on the American land grant model. Here enters then Chief Minister of Uttar Pradesh, Govind Ballabh Pant, who presented a proposal to the Government of India in the year 1956 for establishing a land grant style university in an area around Tarai State Farm in the former Nainital district as a possible site for a rural university. The Indian government signed a contract with few US land grant universities to promote agricultural education in India. Some of the included US universities were the Kansas State University, the University of Illinois, the Pennsylvania State University, and the University of Missouri. Even the concentric semicircles or the rising sun plan of the campus center was actually a brainchild of the Department of Architecture of Illinois University. Finally, on November 17, 1960, the university was inaugurated by the first Prime Minister of India, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, as the Uttar Pradesh Agricultural University, which was renamed as G.B. Pant University of Agriculture and Technology in the year 1972. The area allotted was so large because the university was built in the land grant model. As the name itself states, the land is to be given in grant to the university to not only focus on classroom study but to go on fields, do research and the extension work, and even can raise the funds by selling the produce crops and seeds in the market. To know the functioning of the university, hear it from the man himself.
The university has a threefold function, a threefold responsibility: to communicate knowledge, which we do through teaching; to create knowledge, which we do through research; and to put knowledge to right use, which we try to do through our extension work in the fields and villages which surround us.
He was the first Vice Chancellor of University, Dr. K.A.P. Stevenson. Initially, Illinois faculty served the university in designing its education system and putting in place an effective research and extension system. The faculty of University of Illinois served Pantnagar for 12 years till 1972. Pantnagar University soon became a significant force in the development and transfer of yielding variety seeds and related technology. The Mexican wheat variety is developed by the Nobel laureate American agronomist Norman E. Borlaug were tested in Pantnagar and were released for farmers. The university utilized its 16,000 acres of land to launch one of the largest seed production programs at the time under the brand name Pantnagar Seeds, which became a household name in rural India. The contribution of this university was recognized by Norman Borlaug, who described Pantnagar as harbinger of green revolution.
The best universities in the US and in Britain and in Western Europe said nothing can be done to solve the food situation in India. But look what happened.
Till today, Pantnagar University has developed over 280 varieties of seeds of various crops. Before Green Revolution, the production of wheat was 0.8 ton per hectare, which transforms to 4.7 ton per hectare after Green Revolution, and presently to 6 ton per hectare. India became from food importing nation to food exporting nation. The role and importance of Pantnagar University in the development of agriculture in India was encouraged by various eminent personalities who visited here, including these all. So finally, the history part of the video is over. Now let's see how at present the university looks like. So basically there are two entrances to the university. You can enter either by this gate, also known as the Nagla Gate, or by the main gate on the sideline of NH-109, which is nearer to Rudrapur. Well, let us first enter the university from Nagla Gate. Moving along the same road, the very first college to come into sight is the College of Fisheries. After covering a distance of 2.4 km, here we get a T-point, and let's take a right turn. This is the stadium of university, named Stevenson Stadium. And yes, you guessed it right why it is called Stevenson Stadium. If you are a sportaholic person, then definitely this place is for you. Here you can use various facilities like the gym, badminton court, volleyball court, basketball court, and obviously running track. And you will get the opportunity to showcase your talent on various sports events, including the most celebrated athletic meet. Let us cover the outer semicircle and have a look of hostels which lie along the semicircle. There are some other hostels as well which lie within the semicircle, like the Golden Jubilee, Gangotri Bhavan, Yamunotri Bhavan and Kasturba Bhavan. We will get back to the same location, but let's re-enter the university from the main gate. Here you can see the Pantnagar Airport, and we will enter the university from here. As soon as you will enter the university, this is the first building that you encounter with, called NAHE. NAHE stands for National Agricultural Higher Education Project. This project is in making actually, with the aim to provide necessary infrastructure and faculty for student advancements and to raise the standard of current agricultural system that makes students job ready. The project is proposed on 50-50 cost-sharing basis between the World Bank and Government of India. Now we will go to this region. This is the area around Tarai Bhavan. I think now we should take a right turn and move towards the smaller semicircle. All the respective colleges lie along the semicircle. This is the registrar building, which is responsible for taking care of all your documents. I know it was a joke, but it is what the definition of registrar is. Just behind the registrar, there is this iconic administrative building and the university library. Now let me take you to the Gandhi Park. Here is the Gandhi Hall as well, where most of the official and cultural events are organized throughout the year. Just out of the Gandhi Park, you can see the College of Agribusiness Management. This park is also very couple friendly, and if you are one among those, then definitely this place is for you. This is the market of university named Badi Market. And why it is Badi Market? Because there is another market which is called Choti Market. Reason being, the market is smaller in size as compared to the Badi Market. So being as creative as the person who names these markets, here I stop.